I'm reading this on the eve of my big television show.
No, can I tell you? I was reading the same thing.
No one even knows what I'm talking
about.
There's
an article that's just come out. This interview yesterday.
Paddling out
I'm reading the article.
So am I.
I was asked so many questions about our Big Brother experience.
Yeah.
And I said good things about you.
I can't
that
find them
they've
here.
Left out.
Oh,
so
my
it's,
God.
Okay, so
let me
say,
read the headline out. Jackie O cast doubt about Kyle's sickies during their Big Brother days.
And here's the thing, right?
When it's page after page of shit canning, he's her best mate.
I know. I knew it was all fun, but then I thought, oh, maybe the. Because when I said to him about the sickies, he goes, that's the headline. And I thought, oh really? Uh oh.
Yeah, I know. I could tell everyone why I was really not there.
Oh, yeah? You didn't even tell me. Yeah. Go
no,
on.
They flashed the light.
Don't. Oh, why are you flashing the light?
Well.
Just tell me.
It'd be a big shock.
Go on.
Drug addiction. Are you that shocked you can't speak?
Yeah.
Yeah, drug addiction.
What?
Back in the day, yeah, bad drug addiction. Migraines, self-medicating on my own illegal narcotics.
Right. How bad was it?
Oh, you know, the divorce had happened and it was just, life wasn't great back then. So I buried my face into a big pile of cocaine to try and get over it. And it didn't work. So anyway, I'm better now. Just saying, that was a bad time in my life.
When was that? That was during like your, oh yeah. So were you, yeah, okay, sorry. I don't know what to say.
Anyway, it doesn't matter.
Sorry to hear
we
that.
We all go
glad
through
better.
Things.
Glad you're better now.
That's all right. Yeah, yeah, at least I can get off mine.
Yeah. Who can't get off theirs?
Well, other people, they can't get off it.
Yeah. Well, they can. Everyone can. Everyone can get off it if they need to.
Carly from Wollongong wants to talk. Hi, Carly. Good morning.
Hi, guys. Kyle, you know what? You are one of the most honest people anywhere, honestly. I'm so proud that you can say that on live radio. That's what you went through. That's what you did. You pulled yourself through it. You deal with your shit, and you're probably more honest than the prime ministers. And you know what? My hand's up to you.
Oh, thank you, Anne.
Yeah.
I didn't want to sort of glorify it, but
No,
it just sort of popped
what,
up
just,
and I thought, you know what, I'll tell Jackie. And probably didn't even, I've never probably told you
no,
that
No, you never told me that. No. I mean, I probably suspected that maybe you were partying, but I didn't know that you actually had like a full-blown addiction or anything like that. And I wasn't sure what was going on during that time.
Yeah. Well, that was what was going
because
on.
Because at the time,
the
I just thought,
time,
I thought you just couldn't be asked as well. Like, I thought you weren't that keen to do Big Brother as much as I was.
No, I was too munted to do it.
Yeah. So I thought, oh, he just doesn't really enjoy doing the show, so he couldn't be bothered, you know? So yeah. I wasn't aware fully of what was going on, although I've suspected, yes, at
what
times.
Do you mean? Have you?
Oh, of course, yeah. Thanks, Carly.
Bye, darling.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
Bye.
Hey, how long did that go on for, and when did you get over it?
I think it was just before I got divorced. And then during the divorce, and then a couple of years after that, and then to get off it.
I'm amazed you survived it, to be honest.
To get off the coke.
Because of your blood pressure and stuff.
Oh, yeah, the blood pressure, yeah, that's what could have killed me. They said, listen, your blood pressure is so high continuously that at any stage you could just die. And I'm like, whatever. Hey!
Is that how miserable you were, really?
Yeah, I didn't care if I lived or died.
Wow, that's sad.
And isn't that weird?
Mm. You should have spoken to me. You didn't feel like you
could,
though.
What are you going
to
say?
I was about to have a baby. I was in a different zone. You just didn't care.
You were as fat as a house. You were loved up. I still thought you were great.
But you lost interest in becoming friends with me.
Yeah.
At that point.
Well, you just had a new baby. We're about to have a child. I know. No, I think it was before the baby.
Yeah, well, Big Brother was, but during pregnancy and having Kitty, you were definitely in the thick of it.
Yeah, that forced me to become a drug addict.
Sorry that I forced you by having a baby. Hey, Kate, you're on the air.
Morning, Kate.
Good morning. I just wanted to say that your honesty actually brought me to tears, Kyle, and it's so refreshing to have people like you that can be so honest. When we've got these Muppets in Canberra carrying on backstabbing and everything, and you know what? Your honesty is so refreshing. Thank you.
Oh, well, thank you.
Nice,
that's
Kate.
Sweet of you, Kate. Well, it's not anything I've even said out loud before, so not even to Jackie. So
nope.
It was not planned to be said, but nonetheless.
It was a big thing, yep.
It's
big thing what you did, Kyle.
It's
and,
a little
you know
secret
what?
That I've now don't have to carry around like a monkey on my back. But I'll say if you're self-medicating on anything, alcohol, any sort of drugs, whether it's prescription pills or not, you should try and get off it.
Mm, yeah.
Fine, you want to have a little toot every now and then, whatever. Do your own thing. It's not up to me. But people that are stuck in some sort of rut, it's not a good spot to be in.
Mm.
But I still came in and gave it everything most days.
Oh, yeah, every now and again you'd come in. There was a period, I think, where you were having a lot of sick days.
Yeah, I think the CEO once said I'd had 30-something sick days for half a year. And I thought, someone's counting.
Yeah, doll. They were counting. Trust me.
Oh, well.
They were freaking out.
And now I'm on the bench deciding who's right and wrong tonight.
Mm, how the world changes. Whoa. How's that
fair? Yeah. Just to show you can get out of any rut you're in.